Hello and welcome to another Stitch Mastery tutorial from Amanda at Atlas Knits. In this video, we'll be going over how to set up a namespace, which is something you only have to do once when you first install Stitch Mastery. To set up your namespace, go to Tools and then Preferences. When you first enter the screen, you'll need to click on the arrow button to open Knitting Chart Editor so you can get to the namespace submenu. This namespace is going to be blank if it's the first time you've been in this screen. A namespace is a name that identifies you, and it's used for identifying any stitch libraries that you create. If you send that stitch library to like a tech editor or upload it on the internet or anything like that. So you want to use something that's unique and identifies you so that if someone else ends up with your Stitch Mastery library file, they know whose is whose. Most people use a domain name, but you can also use your Ravelry username URL, which looks something like ravelry.com/people/your username, or even like your Instagram handle or something like that, just something that's going to identify you. One thing to keep in mind is that the namespace cannot be changed on Stitch Libraries and style sheets after it's been created, so make sure that it's something that you don't mind other people seeing and that you don't mind if you can't change it later. For me, I've just used my domain, atlasknits.com, so just type in your namespace and click OK. And now that you've done that, you'll be able to do other things like create Stitch Libraries, text templates, and style sheets. Are you finding value in this free content? Consider becoming a Patreon supporter and getting access to behind the scenes, an exclusive community, and some awesome perks. Check it out at patreon.com/atlasknits.